Now, for Naida Tungupuan, I'm sorry for Naida. For Naida Tungupuan asks, if elected, what will be your first bill and what is it that you want to contribute as a senator?
Budget reform. My first bill will be to reform the budget to make it understandable, transparent, accountable, and people participative.
All right. And Renovic Tangihan asks, what bill will you create to resolve the peace and order situation in Mindanao?
It's not so much of a bill, but rather a consultation of all stakeholders. Mm-hmm. Again, we have to go back to the principle of transparency and people participation. What happened is, in the last time, was that the various stakeholders were not consulted. The Christian settlers were not consulted, and the Lumads, or the in Luzon they call it the Katutubo, mm-hmm. the minorities, mm-hmm. were not consulted. Mm-hmm. That's why there was so much furor over the last peace agreement, and so that should not be repeated. There must be transparency and consultancy of all stakeholders.
Okay, now moving on, Robinson Flores asks, what's your take on shifting to a parliamentary form of government, assuming President Arroyo will not become Prime Minister?
Would not. Okay, but still, I would like to give the presidential system a chance. I don't think it's the system, it's the people who are in power, who have abused the institution, who have destroyed the institutions. Mm-hmm. That's why we're having problems.
Rod Magaru asks, what's your reaction to Estrada's expose of Villar's alleged manipulation on the Philippine Stock Exchange?
Very serious allegations, and they should be really investigated.
All right. Now, this is one of Karen's favorite questions to her guests here on this show. If you were not voting for Noynoy for president, who else would you vote for and why?
If you were not
voting for Noynoy Aquino for president,
but
who,
that's speculative.
Yes, but who else would you vote for? Who else would you consider the next best candidate? Obviously, you think Noynoy is the best candidate, but who would the next best candidate be?
Mar Rojas.
But he's not running for president.
But it's speculative.
Don't want to answer that question. All right, then. Okay, so Tarla, very quickly before we close the interview, why should people vote for you?
Well, number one, TG Gingona would like to reform the budget process because the budget process is how the government will spend the money of the people. The budget process must be first understandable by everyone. It must be transparent. Dapat walang sikreto. Number three, people who spend the money of the people must be made accountable. Mm-hmm. Not years later. We should even put real-time reports in the website, how much is budgeted, how much is being spent on a monthly basis. Mm-hmm. And lastly, people should participate in the budget process because after all, it's their money.
Well, with that, we wish you good luck with the next couple of weeks. And which number are you in the ballot? Tell us.
Number 19.
Number 19. Thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Thank you.
More news when we return. You're watching Head Start with me, Gigi Grande, here on ANC.